Okay, I said earlier that the empirical rule is based on the standard normal. So what we're going to do here is actually verify the empirical rule using the standard normal distribution. Whenever you see the z is very commonly used for a standard normal distribution. Z is distributed normal, 0, 1. So I want to find the probability here that negative 1 is less than z, which is greater than 1. So there's a probability statement. If I draw the picture, I'm looking for this area right there. Now, I'm going to go to TC Stats to do this. The mean is 0. The standard deviation is 1. And n here is still 1 because we're talking about a single observation. Now, the lower bound will be a negative 1, and the upper bound will be a positive 1. If I tap calculate, there's 68.27%. That's why the empirical rule, we say approximately 68%, because what's easier to remember? Approximately 68% or 68.27%? And that 68.27, that's rounded at two places. If I go out further, it'd be 27, whatever. It could go on and on and on and on and on. Okay, the z within two standard deviations, that's what this means. Because remember, z again is distributed normal, the mean 0, the variance and standard deviation are 1. So this would be two standard deviations from the mean. Again, if I draw a picture, and I don't care how silly you think it is drawing these pictures over and over and over again, do it. Because students lose so many points for getting confused on what their bounds are because they won't spend 10 or 50 seconds drawing pictures. Just do it. It'll save you a lot. So out here someplace would be 2. Out here would be negative 2. I'm looking for that area. If I go back to TC Stats, I change this to a 2. And then this to a 2, so it's plus and minus 2. And we know this is supposed to be approximately 95%. And we get 95.45. So again, what's easier to remember? Approximately 95% or approximately 95.45%? That's why we say the empirical rule is a rule of thumb. It gives really close approximations. And the last one, same thing that you expect. Draw another picture. The mean is 0. I'm coming out here to negative 3, out here to positive 3. And we know from the empirical rule this should be approximately all. We actually say 99.7, but approximately all. So if I go back here to TC Stats, I'll change that to a 3. I will change that to a 3. Calculate. And there's a 99.7. It's actually 99.73% when we round 9973 at four places. If I go out farther, then obviously I'd even have even more accuracy. So there's your 99.7% that we use in the empirical rule, or that the empirical rule tells us.